Om Agyarati Maram Nasya Inandana Salakaya Shakshuran Militam Yena Tasmai Shigurve Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manavastam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Tadati Swaparantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Uttapamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamsta Shri Rupam Sagritatam Sahagana Raghunatam Vitam Tam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sagana Lalita Sisakam Vitam Stur He Krishna Karuna Sindh Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesa Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kansana Gorangi Radhe Vrindavaneswari Visvanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakalpatrubhicha Kripa Sindhubhya Evicha Pajitanam Pavanevyo Vaisnavevyo Namo Namah Sri Krishna Chaitanya Pravanchanam Sri Adaita Virada Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vinna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare So, welcome to our Friday gathering and yeah, at the moment, I'm in London, and we are focusing on the Caitanya Charitamrita, and are looking at working on a book for many years. I've been working on my Caitanya Charitamrita study project. It's a major thing, and last year I gave these 140 lectures, which are transcribed, and they're also on my YouTube channel. And yeah, we're trying to build on that material, organize that material, and then once that's all within a good structure, then we'll try and engage many people in this study project, and so that we can make the book. That's the plan. Anyway, so because I'm very busy with the Caitanya Charitamrita, I'd like to also talk about the Caitanya Charitamrita. So I'll begin with the today with the Antya Lila. As you know, Caitanya Charitamrita has three parts: Adi Lila, Madhya Lila, and Antya Lila. And the Madhya Lila is the final part of Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime. So let me Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu was altogether 18 years in Jagannathpur. Out of these 18 years, 6 years he spent in the regular association of all the devotees from Bengal who would come there to visit him for Rati Yatra, and they would stay there. And then stay there for a substantial period of time, at least 3 months or longer, and then they would go back and come back the next year. The final 12 years, Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu goes in his very internal state of consciousness. Now he's free from any, from adjusting to society. We all are experiencing this tension between our social role and our spiritual life. And somehow or other, we try to bring these two together, and many times you hear what about the balance between these two? Yes, and in our state of life, such a balance is needed. But the Caitanya Mahaprabhu, he just basically, the last 12 years, put everything on the spiritual side. Anyway, we'll get there. Let me begin and read the opening verse. Pangam langayate sailam mukhamavati yachutim yatripatamam vande Krishna Chaitanya Miswaram. I offer my respectful obeisances to Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by whose mercy even a lame man can cross over a mountain, and a dumb man recite Vedic literature. Durgame patinendasyas kalpadagatir muhu swakripas yastidanena santasankavalam padam. My path is very difficult and I'm blind, and my feet are slipping again and again. Therefore may the saints help me by granting me the stick of their mercy as my support. So this is an important verse for us, right? Because who can say that this spiritual path is not difficult? Oh, it is difficult for all of us. I'm blind, we're lacking in vision. My feet are slipping again and again. We make so many mistakes, so many things. We know we should do better and somehow or other. It just goes on like that. If we really take an honest inventory of our spiritual performance, I mean, what number would we give ourselves? What mark? You know, who would give himself 10, 1 out of 10? Who would give himself 6? At least 6. 7 is better. 8, 9, 10, that's pretty high. So we can relate to this principle. My feet, I'm blind and my feet are slipping again and again. May the saints help me by granting me the state of mercy as my support. So looking for saints here, reading the works of the great saintly personalities. And as soon as we do, so many dimensions open up. I remember reading Jiva Goswami's descriptions of Vrindavan Dham, and then Jiva Goswami started to describe about the love of Vrindavan Dham itself. I hadn't meditated on that so much. I'd meditated on the residence on Vrindavan, the eternal residence of Vrindavan, the love that they felt for Krishna. But then I didn't really think about Vrindavan and the love that Vrindavan feels for Krishna. But that is what Jiva Goswami is describing. So that is really an example of how by the mercy of the saints, our darkened eyes are opened. And suddenly we see dimensions of devotional service or spiritual life that we never thought of. When we are experiencing weakness, weakness is due to a lack of taste. If there was more taste in Krishna consciousness, we would be very strong. But when there's a lack of taste and our activities become simply duty, then we are feeling a great struggle. And then we wonder, how can I maintain this? So immediately, by the association of the great saintly personalities, we get such taste. We get taste, we get vision, we get swept up in their enthusiasm. In the presence of great saintly personalities, we can do so many things that otherwise might be difficult. Yes. So in this way, Krishna Das is taking us there. So, Sri Rup Sanatan Bhattaragana, Sri Jivu Kupala Bhattadasaraguna, Echai Guru Karan Charan Bandhan, Jaha Hoite Vignanas Abhistapura. This is the other one. Yeah, sparkling is for somebody else. So, Abhistapuram. Krishnadas Kaviraj is praying. I pray to the lotus feet of the six Goswamis, Sri Rupa, Sanatan, Bhattaragunan, Sri Jiva, Gopala Bhatta, and Dasaragunan, so that all impediments to my writing in this literature will be annihilated and my real desire will be fulfilled. So, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, the author of the Caitanya Charitamrita is not just an ordinary writer. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he had come to Vrindavan. He had come upon the order of Lord Nityananda. Lord Nityananda had appeared in his dream. And Lord Nityananda, in the dream, had shown his transcendental form. All his limbs were moving. His entire, he is chanting with a deep voice. He was in an intoxicated state of Krishna praying. Cowherd boys were also chanting the name of Krishna. Lord Nityananda was dressed very opulently. Lord Nityananda had a reddish, blackish complexion. He was wearing jewels, he was wearing silks, and he had a red iron stick. That Lord Nityananda instructed Krishnadas to go to Vrindavan. When Krishnadas saw Lord Nityananda in his dream, then Krishnadas became overwhelmed by ecstatic emotions. He fell on the ground, he offered his obeisances, all in the dream. And when he received the order of Lord Nityananda, then when the dream ended, first of all, he cried in ecstasy. And then he got up and immediately left for Vrindavan. So in this way, the dream, the way that Krishnadas responded to the dream was with great ecstasy, was with symptoms of bhava. And in this way, Krishnadas Kaviraj qualifies himself as an intimate eternal associate of the Lord, one of the devotees who are in the topmost levels of Krishna praying, and who are, he is known in the Gurganadesh Deepika, which is a book that describes who is who in Chaitanya Lila and Krishna Lila. So that Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is Kasturi Manjari, one of the intimate associates of the Astasakhi in Vrindavan. So in this way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami was Krishnadas, he came the order of Vrindavan, and there he stayed under the guidance of Rupa and Sanatan Goswamis. And he thoroughly studied their literatures. It is described in the Caritamrita how daily the devotees of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would assemble in the Radha Govinda temple, and there were thousands of devotees. Temple daily, there were discussions from the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But at one point, the head pujari and his spiritual master were in the line of Kadada Pandit. they both asked, Krishna Das, to write about the later pastimes of Caitanya Mahaprabhu. Why did they ask him? First of all, they knew that he was a great self-realized devotee. Second of all, they knew that he was intimately connected with Rupa Goswami. Actually, Krishna Das, while in Vrindavan, had written a book called the Govinda Lilamrita. This Govinda Lilamrita is a book which he basically wrote for the temple of Govinda. And in there, he based his book on 10 verses of Rupa Goswami. And he wrote an elaborate description of the eightfold pastimes throughout the day of Radha and Govinda. And in the end, then Radha and Govinda are seated under a desire tree. And that's the Radha Govinda on the altar in Radha Govinda temple. So in this way, Krishna Das wrote particularly this book to create a meditation for all for the pujaris and the, who are worshipping Radha Govinda. So this Govinda Lilamrita was a famous book. And in there is a vision of Vrindavan, which goes beyond what we see. What we see is the material world. We see holy places and we see temples that are built on these holy places by people of this world. But Krishna Das, he saw the eternal world. When he saw Radha Kund, he saw it different from us. He saw four jeweled swings on the corners. He saw a beautiful palace of gold and jewels with a jeweled bridge leading up to it in the middle of Radha Kund. In this way, Krishna Das was describing another transcendental reality which goes beyond of what we are perceiving. So in this way, we understand Krishna Das was having a glimpse in the spiritual realm. So Krishna Das in this work, he writes in the Govinda Lilamrita, he writes about just a whole different vision. Now, in the Caitanya Charitamrita, we find a description that when the Lord appears in this world, that the spiritual world also appears with him. So when the deity appears, then we also understand that the spiritual world is also present. So Krishna Das was, as an eternal associate of the Lord, able to perceive that transcendental dimension. So no wonder that Krishna Das was asked to write about the pastimes of Lord Caitanya, since he was a most transcendental devotee. But there was one more reason. And that reason was that Krishna Das had resided at Radha Kund. And Krishna Das had been in close association with Raghunath Das Goswami. Raghunath Das Goswami is the associate of the intimate associate of Lord Caitanya, and also in Jagannath Puri of the secretary of Lord Caitanya, Swarup Damodar Goswami. In those last 12 years, when Lord Caitanya was mostly in his internal state of consciousness, he was accompanied by two major devotees, Swarup Damodar and Ramananda Rai. Raghunath Das was under the guidance. Earlier on, Caitanya Mahaprabhu had placed him under the guidance of Swarup Damodar. Swarup Damodar wrote a diary about those final pastimes, but that diary is now lost. But Raghunath Das had memorized it, and Raghunath Das told Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami. So in this way, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami was a learned scholar in the line of the Goswamis, was a great self-realized soul, was, and he knew the ins and outs of the diary of Swarup Damodar. Therefore, he was the perfect person to write. Then, after receiving the order of the Vaishnavas, then Krishnadas paid his obeisance to Madhu Mahan, and a garland fell from the deity as a sign that the deity also desired Raghunatha or desired Krishnadas to write. So here we get the and he was Kaviraj. He was the king of poets. Raghunath Das elsewhere describes him as Krishna Bhupati, which means the king of the earth. Yes. So Krishna Kavi Bhupati, he calls him, he gives him that title. Kavi, king of the earth, so Kavi Bhupati, Kavi Raj. In this way, he got that title of being the great writer of the Caitanya Charitamrita. That's eternal. So after he revealed in the Govinda Lilamrita that deep spiritual dimension of the whole of the deity worship in Vrindavan. He took it really to the deepest level, not just worshiping dutifully, not just worship the deity according to prescribed rules of regulation, but worshiping the deity really with love and understanding them to be residents of the spiritual world and worshiping them in that mood of eternal residence of the spiritual world. So yeah, that takes us to the deeper meanings that are coming out in the Caitanya. So we are in the Antya Lila, and something will come out of that. So first of all, Krishnadas is praying to the lotus feet of the six Goswamis: Sri Rupa, Sanatan, Bhatta Raghunath, Sri Jiva, Gopala Bhatta, and Dasa Raghunath, so that all impediments to my writing this literature will be annihilated and my real desire will be fulfilled. Glory to the all merciful Radha and Madhav Mahan. I am lame and ill-advised, yet they are my directors and their lotus feet are everything to me. So, in a temple of jewels in Vrindavan, underneath a desire tree, Sisi Radha Govinda, served by their most confidential associates, sit upon an effulgent throne. I offer my humble obeisances unto them. So in this way, he describes the eternal transcendental situation where Radha and Krishna sit on a golden throne and are worshipped by the Astasakhi. But he's also describing the Radha Govinda temple. Sriman Rasara Saram Divam Sivata Tatasti Taha Karsan Venus Vanir Gopir Gopinath Sriistinaha Sri Srila Gopinath, who originated the transcendental mellow of the Rasa dance, stands on the shore at Bamsibad and attracts the attention of the coward damsels with the sound of his celebrated flute. May all confer upon us benediction. Yes. Okay, so these are the three deities of the Gaudiya Vaishnavas: Madan Mohan, Radha Govinda, Radha Gopinath. And through them, we get the deepest worship. A few years ago, we went to Jaipur, and we went to the deities, to these three deities. We went to Karoli, we went to Jaipur, and we deeply went into very deep meditation while we were there. We truly appreciated the great mercy of the six Goswamis, who Madan Mohan is Krishna in the form of the attractor. So when we are at the worship of Madan Mohan, we are busy in the material world, but somehow or other Krishna attracts us and binds us, and we are becoming attached to Krishna. Radha Govinda takes us deeper and deeper. He gives pleasure to the senses. He takes us deeper into transcendental taste and transcendental knowledge, and gradually takes us deeper into the spiritual realm, and we begin to forget the material world, if not altogether, at least partially. But with Radha Gopinath, we have come completely to the spiritual realm, and we are just forgetting everything about the material world. So Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu was now in the Antya Lila, in that mood of just remembering Krishna, and everything else didn't make sense to him. He had liberated himself from this. We recall how Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu was Nimai Pandit. And as Nimai Pandit, he was hiding his identity, and he was acting out the role of a scholar. So when Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu took sannyas, finally, it was a liberation, because finally he could just be fully himself. He didn't have to play any part anymore for anybody. All he had to do was simply just Bodo Krishna, Bhaja Krishna, Koro Krishna Sika. All he had to do was just chant the name of Krishna, worship Krishna, speak about Krishna and Krishna's instructions. In this way, full-time Krishna consciousness. So sannyas in that way was a huge liberation for him. And then we see how that evolves, And by the way, he comes to Jagannath Puri, that grows more and more. And then in his final pastimes, yes, there we see how this ecstatic love of God is just so overwhelming and so strong. And he's so disconnected from the outside world. Sometimes his relation to the outside world is referred to as transcendental madness, because he was just no longer in touch with what was going on in the outside world. That is Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu. He shows a level of absorption which is unmatched. Tell everyone that they should maybe also join us. Yes. So the Caitanya Charitamrita is very nice. And Yogesh has a question already, but you have to wait a while, Yogesh. So, I'll take the question a little bit later, because I wanted to carry on a little bit. So we have read these three mantras, of Jayatam Surato Pangur Mama Mana Matirka. Describing Radha Madan Mohan, then Divya Vindra and Yakub Dumata, describing the mantras of Radha Shila Govinda Devo, describing about Radha Govinda, and then Shiman Rasa Rasarambi, the man Gopinath is Shiestunaha, about Gopinath. So we're seeing three levels that Krishna is revealing himself to us as the attractor, as the one who is giving pleasure to the senses and pulls us in deeper and deeper into Krishna consciousness until we are completely in that spiritual realm. Or sambandha, making the connection, abhideya, getting deeper absorbed, making progress, and prayojana, reaching the ultimate goal, the reality of the spiritual world and the loving exchange of the spiritual world where everything is centered around Ras. Jai Jai Sri Chaitanya Jai Nityananda Jai Dvaita Chandra Jai Gaura Bhaktivinoda. All glories to Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. All glories to Lord Nityananda. All glories to Dvaita Charya. And all glories to all the devotees of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Madhilila Sankhipete Karilun Varmano Antilila Varma Kashishuna Bhaktiga. I've briefly described the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu known as the Madhilila. Now I shall attempt to describe something about his last pastimes, which are known as the Antya Lila. Madhya Lila, Madhya Antya Lila Sutragana, Purvaganda Sanksipi, Kariyacha Vandana. I have described the Antya Lila within the description of the Madhya Lila. Well, in the beginning of the Madhya Lila, Lord Chaitanya, or Krishna's Kaviraj, gives a long list of the pastimes of the Lord. Of later pastimes of the Lord. And these later pastimes of the Lord are both Madhya and Antya Lila. So Madhya begins after Lord Chaitanya takes sannyas and then how he goes through as an acharya and how he tours South India, how he meets so many philosophers, in particularly Venkatabhata and from the Sri Sampradaya. And there's a discussion about Lakshmi Narayan and why Lakshmi. If Lakshmi is chaste, why Lakshmi wants to join in the pastimes of Krishna? Venkatabhata says, there's no difference between Narayan and Krishna. So Lakshmi is chaste when she wants to enter into pastimes of Krishna and associate with Krishna. Yes, but why is it that Lakshmi could not enter? Because Lakshmi is always aware of the opulence of the Supreme Lord. Whereas in Vrindavan pastimes, the opulence of the Lord is forgotten. So Lakshmi was not able to be there. All right, this comes out in a discussion with Venkatabhata and puts the Vrindavan pastimes on a higher level than the Lakshmi Narayan. And in this way, things are unfolding. Next, we are seeing how Chaitanya Mahaprabhu travels further in. When there's a meeting with Ramananda Roy, we find how different levels of devotional service are mentioned. Yad karosi, yad asnasi, yad jahusi, yad asi, yad. Whatever you do, whatever you eat, whatever austerity you perform, do it as an offering to me. Lord Chaitanya said, no, that's external. That is about activities. But what about the consciousness? It's not only what we do, but it must be done with unalloyed love. So finally, after many steps, we come to the love of the gopis, and amongst them, the love of Srimati Radharani, which is like totally, totally selfless. And that love of Radharani, there is absolutely no self-interest. Many examples of the selfless love of the gopis who are simply trying to please Krishna at all times and who have no interest in their own pleasure and yet are totally attached to Krishna. Yes, but asli shiva pada vitunastumam adarsanam mama kankarum tuva yatav vidadatalam pato pranam. Whether he will be present before me, whether he is just not present and makes me brokenhearted, he will always be my unconditional Lord. That is the nature of that mood. So we are looking at Srimati Radharani, who is just thinking of Krishna's pleasure and just thinking of how to increase his love. Of course, Krishna's love is bound to Srimati Radharani, and we get these situations where in public they see each other and she smiles, but only very little because she tries to hide that smile. So, but it shows a little bit in the corner of the mouth, so Krishna can see that she is smiling. And as a result, he also starts to smile. Then Krishna can see that Radharani has noticed that he has smiled in response to her smile. And the corner of her mouth goes a little up, a little further. So then Krishna noticed that Srimati Radharani has noticed that he has noticed that she was smiling. And therefore, again, the smiling increased, and it goes up and down between the two of them. And they just stand there smiling and smiling, and the smiles are increasing until the end, they're just beaming. Who can imagine? Can imagine the loving exchanges and the depth of the love between Radha and Krishna? Something we understand, it is the Caitanya Charitamrita that gradually reveals this Krishna praying to us and these loving dealings to us, and it gives us insight, takes us home, although we are not qualified, not at all. But somehow or other, the Caitanya Charitamrita is taking us along, not only intellectually, but it brings us along emotionally as well. We're growing into it, and gradually we develop attraction. Imagine how it's possible, but we become captured and we become attracted to the pastimes of Krishna. This way, Krishna Das brings us closer and closer to pure love of God. Ami jare krasta nikate janiya marana ancha kona kona lila kariyachya vannana. I am now almost an invalid because of old age, and I know that at any moment I may die. Therefore, I have already described some portion of the Antya. Purva Ligita Granta Sura Anusare Granta Sutra Arisare Ye Nahiliki Tatiliki Avistare. In accordance with the synopsis previously written, I shall describe in detail whatever I have not mentioned. Vrindavana heta prabhu nida chalayala sharup kasai godnavatte patayala. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu returned to Jagannath Puri from Vrindavan, Swarup Damodar Goswami immediately sent news of the Lord's arrival to the devotees in Bengal. Suni sachi anandita Shabha Bhakta Gan, Shabha Milini de Chala Korila Gaman. Upon hearing this news, Mother Sachi and all the other devotees of Navadvipa were very joyful, and they all departed together for Nila Chala, Jagannath Puri. Of course, not Mother Sachi, she stayed home in Bengal, but everyone else. Kulina Grami Bhakta Ore, Jata Kandasi, Archarja Sivananda Shane, Milila Shabhyashi. There's all the devotees of Kulinagram and Shikanda, as well as Advaita Acharya, came together to meet Shivananda Sen. Shivananda Kare Shabara Gati Shamada Shabara Palana Kare Deva Vasistan. Shivananda Sen arranged for the journey. He maintained everyone and provided residential quarters. So in this way, the fight is going. And then we're discussing that dog that went with Caitanya Mahaprabhu, with the group, on the way to Caitanya Mahaprabhu. And because of connected with the devotees and with Shivananda saying, that dog got so much mercy. And then in the end, the dog went back to God. It's simply because of the connection with the devotees that dog got the mercy of Caitanya Mahaprabhu. So in this way, anyone who gets a connection with a pure devotee may also go back to Godhead, although they themselves don't have the qualification. So this is very much the nature of our movement. The nature of our movement is this, is that we are not qualified, but we associate with the same devotees. And with the devotees, they are connected to and all in parampara. Ultimately, we associate with Srila Prabhupada. We associate with the six Goswamis. We associate with Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami and through them to Krishna. And we associate with present Vaishnavas. And in this way, our destiny suddenly becomes auspicious. Otherwise, where would we be if not for that? Everyone can reflect for himself. Okay, I'm going to move on from this particular padog to a further portion, to the part where Rupa Goswami begins to write about his place. Now that okay, I'm done.
Aur din Prabhu Rupa Mini Abbasila Sarvagya Sirumani Prabhu Kaitakavi Pragila.
On the next day, when Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu went to see Sri Goswami, the omniscient Lord spoke as follows.
Krishna re bahir nai kariya braja haite braja chali Krishna kabo na jakante.
Do not try to take Krishna out of Vrindavan, for he doesn't go anywhere else at any time.
Krishna yo yad sambhuto yapuna sushtyatta paraha Vrindavanam pachaya svakachinaiva gacchate.
The Krishna known as Yadu Kumar is Vasudev Krishna. He's different from Krishna, who's the son of Nanda Maharaj. Yadu Kumar Krishna manifests his pastimes in the cities of Mathura and Dwarka. But Krishna, the son of Nanda Maharaj, never at any time leaves Vrindavan. So it is from Lagu Bhagavatamrita. Now, previously, Rupa Goswami had gone to a place in Orissa named Satyabhamapur. And there he had a dream, and this beautiful celestial female form appeared before him and told him that he should not write the pastimes of Krishna in one drama, but he should write two dramas, one drama of the Vrindavan pastimes and one drama about pastimes outside of Vrindavan. So then later, Krishna Das came to Caitanya Mahaprabhu.
Or Goswami. Sure.
Sorry for yawning. It's a little, but that's just the body. So, and then Rupa Goswami, he also got that same order from Caitanya Mahaprabhu to write two dramas. Yeah, so these two dramas are very interesting. One is the Vidakta Madhava and the other one is the Lalita Madhava. So the Vidakta Madhava is a book or a play which describes the great emotional depths that Srimati Radharani is going through in separation. She's in the forest and Vishakha is with her. And she's going through separation because of remembering Krishna, who she's met previously. And so she has this deep attachment to Krishna, and now she's a separation from Krishna. Vishakha is seeing that the separation is getting very problematic. that Radharani is getting beyond herself. Deva Vishakha, to alleviate the situation, Vishakha happens to be a good artist. So she draws this picture of Krishna, which looks just like Krishna. And when Radharani sees that picture, she becomes completely attached to that picture, completely overwhelmed by that picture. And what happens is, now her ecstatic emotions and her separation increases and becomes double from what it was before. So yeah, now it is a major problem. So Vishakha made it only worse. Meanwhile, Krishna is wandering into the forest elsewhere. He is with Sridham and with Madhumanga. And when Krishna is talking, he is acting as if he's completely normal, but maybe he's not, because at one point Krishna says to Sridham, "Sridham, what do you think? Don't you agree that this Radharani is the most beautiful girl in the entire universe? And Madhumangal is, hey, shh, it's his sister." Right? So Krishna is a little confused. He forgets that Sridham is the sister of Radharani. In this way, the whole situation unfolds. Then Srimati Radharani, in that state of complete separation, some brother with kumkum from her body, is writing the name Krishna on a green leaf in the forest. So red kumkum. And then they wander on into the forest. Later, Krishna comes to that place. He sees that leaf and he sees the name and he can understand who wrote it and responds with his flute. And when he plays his flute, Srimati Radharani just goes mad. And now she is saying, "I am to be condemned. Now I am simultaneously attached to three persons. To the person I remember, to the one in the drawing, and now to the flute player." And Vishakha says, and Radharani says, "And because I'm attached to three persons at the same time, I should give up my body." And Radharani says, Vishakha says, "They're one and the same." And Radharani says, "One and the same?" She's acting all in confusion. So this is the essence of the Vidakta Maha. And there are very deep emotions of separation described, love and separation. Then in the Lalita Madhava, which is supposed to be about the pastimes of Krishna out of Vrindavan, it also gets interesting because it begins with the residents of Vrindavan and how they're all in separation. And then Radharani is so much in separation, then she dies. And then they all die. They all die. The residents of Vrindavan die. That's the beginning of the Lita Madhava. So that's a bit shocking. And then they reincarnate and they all come back as the queens in Dwarka. And such Radharani becomes Satyabhama. And Chandravali becomes Rukmini, right? Who is the first and formal queen. And Satyabhama is only a later queen. So she is of secondary in rank. And Rukmini lets her know every time who is the first queen, if you know what I mean. In this way, it's very interesting because although Rupa Goswami is writing about the pastimes out of Vrindavan, he's basically in an indirect way carrying on with the pastimes of Vrindavan. Anyway, we may read these plays, right? and to get some more insight in what love really is, because yes, love is something we talk about. Love is something poetry is written about. But
What love do we know? What love, what do we know about love? How deep are our feelings really? This becomes apparent to us when we are actually reading the Caitanya Charitamrita and the related writings of Srila Rupa Goswami. So in this way, Caitanya Charitamrita is showing us what real love is really about. And that is the gift of Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishna praying, he freely distributes Krishna praying to the most fallen. And here we are discussing such finer topics, such exalted topics that are so difficult to really capture. But somehow or other, although we are ordinary people, still we talk about it. At the same time, we see how Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu is everywhere distributing mercy, everywhere engages people in chanting and somehow or other prasadam and transcendental touchstone, sparsamani, how this enters into the lives of people and transforms the lives of people. And we see how this is happening to us and to people around us. So we see the miracle of Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, which is the external reason for the Lord's appearance, which comes hand in hand, because it's not the symptom of love. As Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu is deeply absorbed in love, he also naturally becomes more and more desirous to just shower others with that love. Just as the resident of Vrindavan, they have milk and yogurt and butter, and they have a festival, and they dress up, and they just get ecstatic, and they just start throwing the milk and the yogurt on everybody, and just spoiling the clothes. And just, in the same way, Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu is there, absorbed in Krishna prema, and then just starts throwing it around like milk and butter and yogurt, and just somehow or other, touching everyone. Everyone, staining them with transcendental love. So we have, of course, already been stained. There is no doubt about it. And so we've already got a transcendental taste somehow or other. And yes, these discussions are aiming to deepen our taste, deepen our meditation, and awakening desire. All right, so now I'll take some questions. I am going to finish in 20 minutes because I'm in the Mantra Lounge in London, and I'm going to do some singing there also. So let me begin with Nama Rupa and see what she is.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. Hare Krishna. I have a more like a little reflection that I have heard that because we don't have a love, that we are so far removed from that love that we are striving for, that the gratitude is a thing we can practice and when we lack love. Can you please say something? Or is that?
Hopefully, there was a little bit of distortion. You said gratitude. And then I missed something.
Yeah, that we can practice gratitude when we lack love, that we are so much removed from that love that we are striving for, and that gratitude is the next best thing that we can start with or go like work from. Okay. Is that true?
It's definitely one of the sentiments, you know, that we should develop gratitude. Yes. I think that personally,
I think when I am turning to Radha and Krishna, and I encounter the limits of my love as I am entering into their pastimes, I turn around to Lord Caitanya, and I get into the mood where Lord Caitanya starts flooding the entire world with the mercy of Krishna consciousness. And then I get into this mood of giving out the mercy. And, you know, then I, as I said the other day, then my life is no longer about living. Then my life is about giving. I don't, most people are thinking about the life they live and they want to live. But then, no, I live to give. I don't think anymore about the life I live, just thinking, what can I give? And when I do that, then I get ecstatic. And then with that ecstasy, I go back to the pastimes of Krishna. And then I enter to another level until again, I meet the limits of my love. And then again, I turn back. Like that. So I think the gratitude is there as part of the appreciation of the gift we have received from Caitanya. But I think that must translate into giving. So I see really that the dynamics are between giving out the mercy, gaining ecstasy, bringing that back to the intimate loving dealings, approaching that love now with ecstasy. And so we can enter a little deeper. And then we go out to give again. Like this. Hare Krishna. Okay. Krishna, Krishna. Okay, it's Tirumala.
Hi, Krishna Guru Maharaj. I just really wanted to say that I enjoyed today's class a lot. And it felt like this week I kept dreaming about that we were going on parikram to in Vrindavan, and we were visiting all of the temples of the Goswamis. And then, it was really nice because even in my dreams this week, you were speaking about Lord Caitanya and all of, like you're speaking about the six Goswamis, and then at one point in one of the dreams, you told me to sing the Sat Goswami Astakam. And then I was reading and singing it from my phone. And then in my dream, you told me to learn it. So yeah, been trying to learn it this week.
Yeah, when we are going to Vrindavan, we are always remembering Sri Caitanya Mahaprabhu on that. It is through Mahaprabhu and his representatives, like Jiva Prabhu, that we can enter in that. Krishna kirtana gama nartana paro primam vritam bovidi kira kira priya jana priya paro. These six Goswamis. Appreciated by all because of their deep absorption in an ocean of transcendental love. So yes, let's turn to them and see where that will take us.
Thank you very much.
Haribol. Swati Krishna Jaya Deva Bhakti Lata.
Thank you. So wonderful that we can meet here together. And you mentioned that in devotional service, it's not only about activity, but also that the consciousness is important. And for me, it seemed like, especially in the beginning, it's all about activity. And so later on, the consciousness is coming in. And I wanted to ask you if you can say something about how they relate to each other in our life and in our practice, the activity and the consciousness. What is more important?
No, the two cannot be separated. Naturally, the activity is always there. The soul is always active. We're always serving Krishna. We're always acting for Krishna's pleasure. But then we also know we do so many things external. Like if we take it to chanting Hare Krishna, you know, we know that we can mechanically chant, or we can chant in deep appreciation. We can chant ecstatic love and so on. So clearly the consciousness also comes in. So it's not one or the other, but it's just another dimension that is added to the activity, any activity. And whatever we do for Krishna, you know, when we do it with real devotion, that's different. You know, like before I went for this Zoom, I quickly put some tilak, you know, so that I would have some fresh tilak, right? You can see, you know. It's on there, all right, isn't it? You know, quite visible. All right, so, you know, put the tilak on my nose. You know, but the that's external. You know, when Prabhupada was putting tilak, despite that, he did it with so much love and devotion. And that's like, you know, fortunately, I know a little more about tilak now than I used to. You know, now I appreciate that we're actually installing deities on the body as we're placing the tilak. Okay, Om Kesavaya Namaha. I know that Lord Kesava is there on my forehead now, and that he resides on the lines between, on the white between the lines. That's where he's actually. So therefore, cannot fill this in. So I appreciate that in this way, I'm directly associating with the Lord. I've become, how our bodies become completely spiritualized by this tilak. So in this way, I can appreciate it a bit more than, okay, this is a symbol that I have to put. So as my hearing has increased, maybe my internal experiences also, my meditation is also growing. Yeah. But, you know, to actually simply by putting tilak or seeing tilak, that love begins to awaken just because of, that's the deeper level of consciousness. So in this way, in the beginning, it's all about putting the right actions in place, right? And to stop the wrong actions. Then when all the adjustments are made and there's only right action, there's chanting, there's devotional service, and it's like, and we fill all our time with it as much as we can, that's all the beginning. And then that is time for the quality, and that is time for the consciousness to come in, to be more attentive. Not only inattentive chanting, but inattentive serving. So attentive, I mean, cleaning can be done mechanically, or cleaning can be done for Krishna. I mean, for the best. Cleaning for Krishna, cooking for Krishna. When Sachi Devi cooked for Lord Caitanya, she cooked in such a way with so much love that it was just like prasadam, like no one had ever tasted, because there was just so much attention and love in everything she made. Just like Yasoda was making special milk sweets for Krishna, because everyone was glorifying Krishna. But this boy, what are you going to do? He has a problem. Nanda Maharaj said, this boy, you know, everyone's glorifying, but this boy is very lusty. I mean, no, really, we feed him the best of the best at home. Then he goes to the neighbors, he eats there as well, and then he's still stealing. Still, he's just never satisfied. It's incredible. And his mother, Yasoda, she goes out of her way to cook special sweets from special milks, from special cows that eat special grass.
and still. Be still. What I'm doing. Yeah. So deep absorption. Offering Krishna the best. When or when will I stop being slack? When or when will I stop cutting corners? When or when will I get really serious about my spiritual life? Stop wasting time. Use every moment to remember Krishna. When or when will that day arrive? Yeah, these kind of things. Okay, is that all right?
Thank you very much.
Thank you also. Now, Bhakti Lata tells you, I want to write to your mother, and I cannot find the offering that she wrote to me. You know, can you be of any help and get it to me again?
Yes, I can surely send it to you.
And she's also in the meeting.
Okay, so, you know, please tell her, I'll tell her, I'm really sorry. I'm trying to write a response, but it's buried under so much mail that I don't know where it is anymore. Yeah. So I looked for it several times and just can't find it. So if you send it again, I'll write you a reply. Bini Madhava, Madhavi.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj.
Hare Bhakt.
O great senses, O glories to Shri Prabhupada, O glories to you. Guru Maharaj, I have a question not related to the class, but to what happened for the France movement. That recently we had this issue for New Mayapur. So we had one discussion that happened that Krishna is merciful. He will protect his house by himself. I mean, he is the doer, he is the master. But then one question came that why did Parishishwara not save his house then? Or like, why did he allow it to be lost?
Yes, no, Krishna will not necessarily do that. First of all, let me give a little context for all the devotees. At the moment in France, there is a real problem in that in Mayapur, the French government put serious notices and about fixing up the building, bringing it up to code, or else they will close it. And that's both the castle and the guest house, I understand. So it takes serious amounts of money, and they are trying to raise the money and trying to get the work done. But it's a major challenge, very difficult for them. So I am very sympathetic to this cause, and I think if all of you can help, I would appreciate if someone has a link to there and can post it here, that would be really good. Otherwise, I'll post it later on the disciple group because I can't do it simultaneously while I'm talking to you. Now, about Krishna. No, Krishna wants us to do something. You know, Krishna is, we are challenged now, and now we have to rise to the occasion. It's not just Krishna will do, and don't worry, just go back to sleep. And Krishna will do everything. Yes. No. Krishna wants us to somehow or other do it. That is our duty. So, okay. See, Surabhi Kunja posted it now. A GoFundMe. So if all of you can help a little bit or a lot,
that will be very good, because it is a special place where Srila Prabhupada went, and we would really like to see that, yeah, that this project can continue and continue to flourish and flourish. But Krishna wants us to do already.
Guru Maharaj, yes, this is one difference that I see or I notice, that we have all these references for new. I mean, it's not good that I'm comparing also, that he has been to New Mayapur. This is the place he has visited. But for Paris, we cannot even say that, because we have already lost the place where Prabhupada was. And now where he is, we just have the murti that he has in store.
You still have the deed. You still have Radha Parishiswara. And, you know, in many places in the world, there were different temples where Prabhupada has been, which we don't have now, because Prabhupada was not just about making monuments. Prabhupada was about a dynamic movement, and going from one temple to another is something he did himself. So that is fine. But we do hope that Radha Parishiswara will get a place more central in Paris eventually, so that we can really reach out to Les Parisiens and to the people of Paris, and no longer be in the banlieue, in the greater area around Paris where we are now, in Sarcelles. No, we want Radha Parishiswara back in the heart of Paris and make many devotees. So my prayers are there for Radha Parishiswara and for Radha Govinda Madhava and Krishna Balaram in La Nouvelle Mayapur, so that everything will flourish in La France.
Thank you, Guru Maharaj. Thank you.
Forgive me my joking with the French language. I can't resist. I like language, so I have to play with it.
Beautiful. There was Ramanaji who was trying to imitate you speaking French here.
So my French is very exalted. It is not easy to imitate. you have to practice for a long time.
It's very beautiful.
Just joking.
Thank you, Maman.
Thank you. Well, it's the last one. So, Tulasi Manjari, are you using something like WhatsApp?
Yes. Actually, it's Zoom now, but yeah, normally I can use WhatsApp too.
Yes, you can.
Okay.
I was looking for your WhatsApp.
Okay. I can send you another message if you want, because I have sent you a message lately and there was no answer, but it's okay. Actually I have a question, and also have like a philosophical question, and I have a question for visit to America. Okay, so my first question is about Harinam. Like, I'm more and more involved in Harinam. This is one of the services I enjoy the most, and but I have more and more like invitation to organize like Harinams and yoga centers. And which is nice, but they are being paid, you know, like my friend Pradyumna Prabhu, he's like asking like $30 the entrance, which I wasn't sure what to think about, you know, asking Lakshmi for for Harinam activities, although we do Harinam in the street, like standard ones. We continue to do that. So would you, do you give us your blessings still for even if we ask Lakshmi for these events?
Yes, we can do this. We can do it. Okay. So it's nicer if there's no, but the holy name is going out. I am now actually in a yoga center in a mantra lounge. You can hear the kirtan in the back. I'm going on in a few minutes for my kirtan in the mantra lounge. So I got to keep my answer short, actually. As far as America, I'm coming to America on the 23rd of May. I reach New York. Then I go on 25th. So from 25th to 30th, I go to, or to 31st. 25th to 31st, I'll be in Salt Lake for Utah, for the Sadhu Sangha, and a few days rest in between to get over the jet lag. And then I go back to New York, be in New York for Atiyacha. I got the invitation for Toronto. I can't make it to Toronto. It's not going to happen. Although I like the invitation, but Dr. Mark Swami sent to me, I have to. So what are we going to do? Maybe you can come to New York.
Yeah, I'd like to. Only thing that's kind of limiting me is like I'm not vaccinated and it's like complicated. Maybe I should get vaccinated to this. I mean, you know, the purpose is higher. And actually, I asked him to invite you to Montreal Ratha Yatra, which is the 9th and 10th of July, but maybe it's still too far for you. Okay.
I have to go. I have to be back. I have a thing in London. I'll go back and forth. Anyway, otherwise I'll meet you online, you know, what to do. I don't want people who are not comfortable about vaccination to do that, just to meet me, that would make me feel uncomfortable. I'm happy to see you healthy online without being jabbed. That's if you're comfortable with that. But yeah. You know, I do want to give you initiation one of these days. I mean, somewhere, somehow, if you would accept it from me, that would be nice. Yeah, I gotta escape. Although I love to chat, but we can if you catch me on WhatsApp and we can try and talk privately. Because right now I got time to start a kirtan. And I'm not getting paid.
Okay,
I'm not getting paid. Okay.
All right. So thank you for your answer. Thank you for the class. It was very inspiring, as always.
Thank you.
Talk to you soon. Hare Krishna.